Petitioners have sought the legal action to exhume the body of former President Ferdinand E. Marcos after being buried at the Heroes Cemetery in Manila. Marcos was laid to rest in a secretive ceremony last week at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani after the Supreme Court endorsed a decision by President Rodrigo Duterte. Those against the burial are calling for the court to cite the Marcos family in contempt and exhume the remains of Marcos because petitioners had not been given 15 days to appeal.
They are separate but interrelated because the main argument here with respect to the motion for exhumation and the petition for contempt would be the fact that the decision was still not final and executory. That motion to exhume should take precedence because that would first emphasize that the burial was made pending the finality of the decision. Number two, the burial was made in order to preempt the filing of the motion for reconsideration.
And joining us now via Skype from Boston is Dr. Joy Barrios, a lecturer at UC Berkeley on South and Southeast Asian Studies, as well as on Philippine cultural politics. Thank you for joining us here on BA, Dr. Barrios.
Thank you for inviting me.
President Rodrigo Duterte has said that, hero or not, Ferdinand Marcos was a soldier and therefore deserves to be buried at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani. Your take on this?
Well, there's no doubt he's a soldier, he was a soldier. But the question is, was he an honorable soldier? So there have been questions about his medals, and several people have investigated this, including Colonel Bonifacio Villego, also Dr. Alfred McCoy, and even the U.S. Army, and they all came into the conclusion that the medals are fake, and there was no such thing as the Maharlika, which he supposedly put up and led. So, and because of this lying, people cannot consider him to be an honorable soldier.
Previous presidents have refused to allow Marcos to be buried in the Heroes Cemetery, Joy. Now, how will this affect Duterte's political legacy?
Of course, it will definitely affect his political legacy because many people have expressed disappointment and even a lot of anger at what he has done by allowing the former president to be buried. However, we should also bear in mind that this is very early in his term, and so much will still be done in the next 5 years, and so everything will be considered as we assess his political legacy.
How likely is it that the Supreme Court would order the exhumation of Marcos' remains following petitions filed by human rights victims under his rule?
I don't really think that the decision will be reversed and that they will order the exhumation of the remains. We have to remember that majority voted to uphold the Duterte decision. It's very likely that the same people who voted to uphold this decision will vote that way again. Nevertheless, I think it's the right and of the petitioners to continue to seek justice. All victims of martial law should continue to seek justice for what has been done to them. And I think what's positive right now is that youth, students, people from different sectors of Philippine society have come together to protest this decision.
Thank you very much for joining us via Skype from Boston, Dr. Joy Barrios of UC Berkeley.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.